Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. The second integrated flight test, IFT-2, of the SpaceX Starship launched for the second time on November 18th, 2023. As you all already know, people were excited about it, but it didn't go well. Right after the rocket's parts separated, the big booster exploded, and the upper stage vehicle also blew up before reaching the planned height. SpaceX called this unexpected explosion a rapid, unscheduled disassembly. But what now? What'll happen next? To give you a little background, originally SpaceX planned to launch on November 17th, but there was a problem with a part called the grid fin actuator, so they had to delay it by a day. They quickly fixed the issue by replacing the faulty part and made some other necessary changes. On the day of the launch, it went up on the booster for its eighth and final time. Everything looked good during the checks, and Elon Musk shared pictures of the rocket's engines, which were installed a year ago. 7 hours before the launch, the area around the launch site was closed off, showing that SpaceX was ready. 4 hours before the launch, the propellant farm started doing its job preparing the fuel for the rocket. As the countdown reached 35 minutes before liftoff, SpaceX showed pictures and videos of the rocket, highlighting the long trail it left in the sky. People appreciated that SpaceX kept the countdown short so everyone could enjoy watching the launch. Then, John Innsbrucker, who works for SpaceX, said that the clamps holding the rocket in place were released. This meant the rocket was about to take off once it had enough power. Just 90 seconds before liftoff, the 13 engines were checked one last time to make sure they could steer the rocket properly. And at T-minus 40 seconds, there was a short pause because they found a small issue, but SpaceX had up to 30 minutes to fix it, although they were limited by a 20-minute launch window. After the brief hold, the countdown continued. Just 5 seconds before liftoff, the water system turned on. Then all 33 engines started, and the huge rocket at 7:03 a.m. in Boca Chica, Texas, went up in the sky and separated from the upper part of the spacecraft. As it went through a point called Max Q, the rocket's speed exceeded that of its first flight thanks to more thrust. However, things didn't go as planned, and the rocket had problems shortly after liftoff. As a result, instead of landing safely in the Gulf of Mexico, the Super Heavy exploded when it fell back to Earth. At first, Booster 9, the part of the rocket that comes back down to Earth, performed well with all engines working. It was supposed to fly around Earth and land in the Pacific Ocean near Hawaii. The data showed that the rocket was following the right path, and having all engines working properly was a big deal. This launch was a success, showing improvements in stability and performance compared to earlier flights. The recent Starship flight had a crucial moment when it separated from the booster. This time, SpaceX tried a new maneuver called hot stage, which they hadn't done before. They focused on the new hot stage ring and the booster's main engines. The booster's engines stopped, and the outer two rings of the engine shut down one after another, like a collapsing star. The small shutdown reduced stress on the vehicle by avoiding a sudden change in speed. While the center engines kept pushing, the Raptor vacuum engines and then the center Raptor engines ignited. Ship 25 moved away from Booster 9, creating a visible shockwave. However, there was a problem with one Raptor engine on the booster, and that's what basically caused multiple engine failures and a complete breakup. If you take a look at the broken skirt section, you'll see an explosion at the bottom of the methane tank, suggesting that the flight termination system was activated. The connection with Starship was lost. Even though the booster was lost, Ship 25 still seemed to be on a good path initially, reaching a speed of over 24,000 kilometers per hour. But around 8 minutes after liftoff, when it was at an altitude of about 150 miles or 250 kilometers, telemetry of the ship was lost. All six ship engines suddenly turned off, followed by the explosion, causing Starship to be destroyed over the Gulf of Mexico. SpaceX's test launches often have things going wrong, like explosions, which sometimes makes people think the test didn't work. This time, though, the launch achieved its main goals, as shown by the excited cheers from SpaceX staff in California. In the first test flight, the rocket went out of control after Starship didn't separate, and then it exploded in the air. This time it did better than before, so it's considered a successful experimental rocket launch. To appreciate the effort, NASA's administrator, Bill Nelson, congratulated the teams involved in the test on X, formerly Twitter, after the launch, saying, "Congrats to the team who made progress on today's flight test." On November 18th, SpaceX tried a new way for the upper part of the spacecraft to separate from the rocket, calling it hot stage separation. And surprisingly, it worked the first time they tried it. But after that, things went wrong. The failure might cause SpaceX some problems. They might need more approval from the FAA for their next launch. SpaceX doesn't like this because it takes a lot of time. Even though the $2 billion program failed, SpaceX is okay with taking risks and testing prototypes quickly to make better designs. Elon Musk, the visionary behind SpaceX, envisioned Starship supplanting the Falcon 9 rocket as the linchpin of the company's launch enterprise. Given NASA's tight schedule for lunar missions, SpaceX faces intense pressure to produce results promptly. Investors and industry pundits always expect a swift resumption of tests, driven by both Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, evaluation, and the imperative to address any technical hurdles. Despite potential setbacks, SpaceX is committed to maintaining an impressive frequency of Starship flights in the upcoming year. So, to sum it up, it's noteworthy that Starship's second test mission surpassed its initial attempt on April 20th of this year, which encountered a failure at stage separation, resulting in an explosion. Despite this accident, SpaceX deemed the second endeavor a success. The latest telemetry signal from the recent launch indicated Starship's altitude at 148 kilometers, or 91 miles, well exceeding the 62-mile, or 100-kilometer boundary, delineating the edge of space. Although SpaceX fell short of the intended velocity, it accomplished key milestones seamlessly. The heat shield tiles require refinement, but the hot staging process proved successful. Issues with the booster may be linked to propellant feed or pressure failures. The launch site, inspected by SpaceX, remains intact, with minor damage to the ship's arm. We'll hopefully get to know more about this unexpected and unfortunate explosion on the second integrated flight test, IFT-2, of the SpaceX Starship in the future. But today, that's all we have for you. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.